Hello, friends and family of Faith Lutheran Church. This is Pastor Mike Wygan giving you your daily devotion and update for April 1st, 2020. How many times in the last couple of days have you heard or read something like this? It's going to get worse. Not fun words to hear, and they put a little knot in our stomach. It's an ominous place to be. But you know, the experiences we have in life and the experiences we're even having now, sometimes God can really use those to teach us and to help us appreciate some of the things that He's done on our behalf. I think that's true as we look to the position Jesus is in the video devotional, the Passion History we're about to look at today. Jesus was with his disciples in the Garden of Gethsemane. You can still go to the Garden of Gethsemane today, and if you do, it's at the bottom of a hill. And when you look up, you see the wall of Jerusalem. And in Jesus' day, you would have seen the Temple Mount there. It's a little bit intimidating. Far more than that was Jesus' knowledge of what was about to come. Jesus knew it was only going to get worse. His betrayal around the corner, his suffering, his excruciating death awaited him. We see the pangs and the struggle that even Jesus had as he soldiers on and for the love of us is willing to go forward, even when it just keeps getting worse. View now the Gospel of our Lord recorded in Matthew chapter 26, verses 36 through 56.
Then Jesus went with his disciples to a place called Gethsemane. And he said to them, "Sit here while I go over there and pray." He took Peter and the two sons of Zebedee along with him, and he began to be sorrowful and troubled. Then he said to them, "My soul is overwhelmed with sorrow to the point of death. Stay here and keep watch with me." Going a little farther, he fell with his face to the ground and prayed, "My Father, if it is possible, may this cup be taken from me. Yet not as I will, but as you will." Then he returned to his disciples and found them sleeping. "Couldn't you men keep watch with me for 1 hour? He asked Peter. "Watch and pray so that you will not fall into temptation. The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak." He went away a second time and prayed, "My Father, if it is not possible for this cup to be taken away unless I drink it, may your will be done." When he came back, he again found them sleeping because their eyes were heavy. So he left them and went away once more and prayed the third time, saying the same thing. Then he returned to the disciples and said to them, "Are you still sleeping and resting? Look, the hour has come, and the Son of Man is delivered into the hands of sinners. Rise, let us go. Here comes my betrayer." While he was still speaking, Judas, one of the 12, arrived. With him was a large crowd armed with swords and clubs, sent from the chief priests and the elders of the people. Now the betrayer had arranged a signal with them. "The one I kiss is the man. Arrest him." Going at once to Jesus, Judas said, "Greetings, Rabbi," and kissed him. Jesus replied, "Do what you came for, friend." Then the men stepped forward, seized Jesus, and arrested him. With that, one of Jesus' companions reached for his sword, drew it out and struck the servant of the high priest, cutting off his ear. "Put your sword back in its place," Jesus said to him. "For all who draw the sword will die by the sword. Do you think I cannot call on my Father, and he will at once put at my disposal more than 12 legions of angels? But how then would the scriptures be fulfilled that say it must happen in this way?" In that hour, Jesus said to the crowd, "Am I leading a rebellion that you have come out with swords and clubs to capture me? Every day I sat in the temple courts teaching, and you did not arrest me. But this has all taken place that the writings of the prophets might be fulfilled." Then all the disciples deserted him and fled.
We'll go to our Lord in prayer. In our prayers today, we give thanks on behalf of Keith and Violet Pouch, celebrating 60 years of marriage this coming Saturday. We also pray today for those who serve in our military. Maybe not as noticeable right now as healthcare workers, still the functions that they're performing, especially as you look at the National Guard in this time of crisis, functions we truly appreciate, and we want to keep them in our prayers. We pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for the gift of marriage and the 60 years with which you've blessed Keith and Violet. Please continue to keep them in their care. May they always be a blessing to each other and to those around them. Keep them in the faith, Lord, until that time when you call them both home to heaven. Dear Heavenly Father, our hearts are in distress when we think of the many young men and women in our land who are called to military service to defend their country at great personal sacrifice, sometimes contrary to their own convictions. Keep them from becoming bitter or discouraged. Help them realize that your divine providence always controls their lives, and that come what may, all good things will work together for their ultimate good. Grant them courage to perform their duties well. Keep their minds and bodies pure. Shield them from harm and temptation. In doubts and fears, give them a conquering faith. Enable them ever to live and to serve, that they will be your effectual witnesses. Dear Lord, soon come and end all strife, establishing peace among the peoples of the earth. Meanwhile, we entrust your loved ones to your guidance and care. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you for tuning in today. Just a reminder, if you would like to view one of the Lenten series sermons, you can do so on our Faith Lutheran website, faithlutheranfdl.org. May God bless you richly the rest of this day.